Examination of varicose veins. Varicose vein is an elongated, dilated and tortuous vein in the subcutaneous layer. On inspection, we will first inspect the vein and then the ankle and the foot. On inspection of the vein in standing position, first note the site and extent of the varicosity and whether it conforms to the anatomical path of the long or short saphenous veins. Long saphenous varicosities run from the front of the medial malleolus upwards along the anteromedial aspect of the leg, knee and the thigh to end at the saphenous opening just below the inguinal ligament. The short saphenous varicosities run over the posterior aspect of the calf to converge and end at the center of the popliteal fossa. Some varicosities may not conform to these anatomical pathways and are termed as stray varicosities. So inspect the long saphenous system, the short saphenous system and their relation to the present varicosity. For this, you must examine the leg from all the sides, front and back. Now inspect the length of the varicose vein for a blowout or a localized bulge in the vein indicating incompetent perforator. This is a blowout in the leg. In this patient, two blowouts are seen in the thigh. When a blowout is seen, mark it with a skin pencil. Next, inspect the saphenous opening below the inguinal ligament for a saphena varix. Saphena varix is a blowout over the saphenofemoral junction and it indicates saphenofemoral wall incompetence. If a saphena varix is seen, ask the patient to cough and look for a visible cough impulse. Now look for dilated veins over the lower abdomen above the inguinal ligament converging onto the saphenous opening. These are the superficial circumflex iliac, superficial inferior epigastric and superficial external pudendal veins which enter the long saphenous vein just before it joins the femoral vein. Now raise the leg to 60 degrees and check whether the varicosity collapses or not. An uncomplicated varicose vein will always collapse on raising the leg, but if it is secondary to pelvic vein thrombosis or arteriovenous fistula in the leg, then it will not collapse when the leg is raised. Holding the leg elevated to 30 degrees or more, ask the patient to cough and look for a cough impulse at the saphenous opening. If a saphena varix is present, it will be seen to bulge out and a retrograde venous pressure wave